speaking it, Blacklist will have range, they will have front to back, and they can also engage in these fights. So let's just get straight into the Land of Dawn for game number one. Let's see if it pays off for the Brazilians here as Blacklist and Cade get into the first game in the Land of Dawn.
I'm excited to see how this is going to be played because Luiz is going to be the one who's on this Benedetta going up against Oheb in the gold lane. Very exciting stuff. More importantly, so I'm a little sad that, you know, the high loss coming in from Takashi kind of forcing Blacklist International, and especially for a player like Edward to go on something personally, I believe, super boring hero on this Uranus. I was really hoping Esmeralda. I was really, really hoping for Paquito.
Well, both heroes will not fare well against the Hylas, and you are actually on point on Key just forcing that hero onto Blacklist International. As boring as it is, you if you are a fan of like big macro plays, maybe that will not be too boring for you as this Uranus from the Philippines. We saw that from both Delarski as well as Edward. They want to play it to make the space for the rest of the other players to be able to fight. So by the mid game, around the maybe 9 minute mark until the 15 minute mark, you're gonna see this Uranus just cut the lanes, proxy as we might call it.
Yep, it's all about control, right? I mean, I think nothing's really going to happen here unless somebody makes a mistake. But level 4 is when we're expecting most things to happen. Because Keith, very ultimately, ultimate dependent here, especially when it comes down to these team fights.
Yeah, you can see the Mount of Chakra already being popped up. Luiz has actually been taken really low. Oh my god! Oheb jumps in and Wise is there to capitalize. It's going to be him picking up the first blood clean by Blacklist International. Luiz a bit too much than he could chew there in that bottom, that top side. And Edward, this is the thing. If Cade wants to go to that bottom side, play for it, you are not going to be able to kill that Uranus. It isn't going to be a fun time. It should have been them going and rotating to that top side in the early stages. Sure, they want to get control, but is it really good right now? Because look, right now, wait a minute. Real World Invasion is going to be Force King all the way to run away, but is it going to be him taken down? Very questionable decision-making as of right now for the side of Cade.
I mean, they need to wake up right now. They can't be making mistakes like this against Blacklist International, who's seemingly a little more sharp today.
Yeah, they're very sharp. You see, again, very easy turtle take from them. They found that King was there, and Haji did not even hesitate. They have not much stuns in there, but they do have the slow. If you couple the SS slow as well as the Eve slow, it's almost as if it's a stun. And they also caught King quite low in that turtle area. Top lane, they were also very good when it comes to execution, as Oheb just literally destroyed that Benedetta. The range versus melee match is way too good.
Yeah, but looking for the airstrike, we'll be able to pick Venus off of the Land of Dawn right there, but Mikey is the one who gets the kill. Now, sure, they do get a kill on the board. I'm not trying to complain, I'm not trying to nitpick, but they would want, you know, literally anyone else except for Mikey to get those kills on the board. But Edward already starting to become a nuisance now. He has that. Oh, wait a minute. Actually, the engage comes in and it's gonna be Edward just instantly burst it down, forced to flicker away. I was about to say he has a consecration. It's gonna be hard to burst him down, but Nathan just comes in out of nowhere with that guiding wind.
I mean, King was already stacked up before Edward was even walking into the jungle. So he's gotta be really, really careful because the moment he's stacked up and he drops down that entropy, the auto attacks, most people would underestimate it. But, oh, wait, hold on. Luiz might be in some trouble here.
Oh, he's in a lot of trouble right now. But the bottom side, Edward's going to get picked off. Luiz now in the midst of it all. It's going to be Wise dashing in, almost getting the kill. But, wow, great plays by the Brazilians. Trading, getting a turret, and actually not losing a kill in the process right there. Maybe even not losing a turret because Luiz, before he backed away, that was a wave cleared.
Yeah, he clears the wave before he gets out and eventually was, you know, was able to escape without dying, which is great for Key, as they will live to see another day. However, top lane is still being taken out by Blacklist International. This is very scary, as the Clint as well as the Yeast and Shield deals so much damage against turrets, and this battle already available for Oheb.
Oh, Luiz, perfect eye for an eye, actually. But he's actually going to go back in right there, able to clear the waves right now as Mikey comes into that top side, maybe just show himself up to pressure the members of Blacklist International. But Cade, so far, not doing too bad. not doing too shabby here as Blacklist will try to look for control in that turtle side.
Yep, I mean, they're opening up the map here, and Edward's doing a good job making sure he's the one face checking. He knows he can take the damage for a good amount of time, plus he still has the consecration up.
Oh, Lorenzo seeing a glorious pathway being used. It's gonna be Venus all the way in the midst of it all. He's still using the ultimate, still gonna be bursted down though. Mikey has nowhere to go, and Tekashi, he is in the midst of it all, trying to get some kills on the board, but it's a 2-for-1 right now. There's nothing that Tekashi can do at this point. Ohem is just gonna clean it up. Wise comes in for the kill, and Luis will try to get a trade, but that was amazing again. 5th minute mark for Blacklist, already starting the group up, showing amazing, amazing plays on the board. King will be able to take that orange buff.
You see the rotation from Blacklist International is very fluid. Top lane push, and then mid lane clash, eventually the turtle, and then some pokes into the bottom lane. It almost, a stopover into that orange buff, but they saw King in there. If King was just a little bit too late, maybe 2 seconds late than taking that orange buff, surely Blacklist International would have taken it. So very fluid movements coming up from Blacklist International. That's why they're able to amass a 2.3k lead 5 minutes in.
I mean, Blacklist International knows how to push their lead. They know what to do after the fight to convert a team fight in towards gold. However, I am still worried about Prime. His positioning in that last fight was a little questionable, and more importantly so, losing that flicker, even though still has Wings by Wings, is a little concerning.
Oh, real world inflation. Luis is going to go in, but it's going to be Mikey picked up out of nowhere right there with the airstrike, almost taking Haji down. It is Venus on the Estes. You know the healing is just going to be insane, and that's exactly what happened. The poke, the range, and the sustain from Blacklist.
Oh my goodness. You see, oh my, Venus really timed that perfectly well. It's a good thing that Key did not overcommit though, because some teams are always baited when the Moonlighting Merchant is not yet popped by Oh My Venus. They always say that when they're trying to go for the kills and they see someone very low, they overcommit, but this time, it's a good thing that Kid did not overcommit. However, Blacklist International, this is a 4-1 placement in the map, as the Uranus will be away from his team.
Oh, Edward actually goes in onto King right now, still taking very low, but Mikey is the one to pick up the kill once again. Blacklist International, though, they do not want to give the objectives for free, the kills for free. They have rotated to this bottom side. The second tier turret has been chunked to almost half HP as the orange buff will be taken away. Kate, though, look at them. I really like the setup coming in from them. They see Blacklist on that bottom side. They don't instantly recall. They went for that mid, cleared it up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, in terms of micro, they're learning and starting to pick up on the habits, especially for Edward. They're kind of figuring out how he likes to kind of get out of these situations, which walls that he most commonly uses, and looks to punish it with their own rotations. Mikey, coming in from that angle, he could have gone the entire long way in towards the enemy, Blacklist's jungle, but now the next fight's already begun.
Yeah, look at the Predator Airstrike, able to deal some damage right there, and that's gonna be Haji stunned up, still able to flicker away with the help of Venus, gets back up to half HP, and that is just the healing doing wonders for Blacklist. Prime gets taken down.
It's 7 minutes in, they're gonna group up, and for sure they'll take this turret in the mid lane, and this is massive for Blacklist International. They're not gonna stop. Gonna be waiting for the next wave of minions and then push it against Kid. Haji's ultimate is almost up again in a few seconds, and they are itching to use it.
This is the time where Kade needs to go and pull the trigger to exactly do that, man. But Tekashi, he can't melt the members, and he's the one actually who gets melted down. Blacklist are just so good, you see, every single time. Even when they're pushing, whenever they're in the lead, their positioning is on point.
Goodness. You see that Tekashi with only the dominance eyes thought that he can last against Blacklist International, but you can see that Blacklist International already formed their bubble, and they're going to be continuously pushing. Another 4-1 for Blacklist International. Uranus away from the team and 4 in the top.
Oh my god, Luis is just so aggressive, and Wise actually gets caught out right there. King picks up the kill, and they're going to go for the re-engage onto Venus. He pops the ultimate, but he's going to get bursted down by the Nathan, and that is the kill picked up by Kade. Right now, it is a 2-for-0 as Kade look for more on the board. Haji has a shield from the real world inflation, and there you go. Prime joins in, goes in for Ohem, still forcing that flicker away, and Blacklist will be able to run away for now, but maybe not for long, because King, he's looking for something. Although Haji's able to zone him away, it's going to be the Feather Airstrike popped in again. Haji's still dodging away, and that's going to be Ohem picked off on the board. King picking up a killing spree, and that is a trade. Actually, Prime going and overextending a little bit too much, but the fight doesn't end there. Mikey goes back in for the Circling Eagle, knowing that Edward is just so, so tanky. Will just shoot the back away. Luis will lose his life in turn for that mid lane turret, but wait a minute, he's still alive. Whoa! What is this? He's actually going to be able to dodge away from the Mountain Shocker. Oh my god, Haji will be able to pick it up though. Unstoppable for him. Blacklist with the lead still, but Cade coming back.
Yep, at least they bought enough time so that now Blacklist doesn't have a very comfortable timing to do this Lord. They're going to try, but you can see that the rest of Cade is going to be walking in to look for position. But in this fight alone, really, really nicely done coming in. I mean, they punished Wise for getting too far forward, and Takashi is like, no, Law and Order, I'm going to keep you in place. And with that, it's going to be very simple to take him out.
And the kill on Doohab is icing on top of that clash. Unfortunately, the Prime was outplayed by Haji. The movements coming, the footwork for this even. Now they want more.
Oh, they do want more. Circling Eagle onto Venus, and he's going to get stunned up. The damage not just yet there, but it is going to be enough. That final blow was perfect. But now, look at it. It's going to be Blacklist with the re-engage, popping in the real-world manipulation, but instant disengage from the side of Cade. And they just pull the fight back and forth. They have Venus, and now they have the lead. What they need to do is keep on doing this. They are doing it perfectly.
Mm-hmm. Yep, they just got to farm Oh My Venus while they still can, because they look at how many resources they had to dedicate. They didn't use their battle spells, but so many ultimates just to take out Venus. There's no point continuing that fight because Blacklist International still have a large majority of their resources. I think Cade make a really, really good argument against Blacklist International. However, they're going to continue to use these neutral objectives as bait. I think it's going well. They're following their keys to victory.
Blacklist International, since they have pulled yourself together on Oh My Venus, mm-hmm. now they have him once again. Let's see though, as Cade already is taking some farm. And in fact, they have taken the lead down to 2.0, which in a way is still winnable for Cade. What they can do now is use Louise as their split pusher. Maybe just their way to kind of blow the minion waves in their favor. As Blacklist International, the advantage that they have right now is Vision from the Mana Chakra. And they want to use this as a way to kind of control the Lord area. Wait. As in a way, you know, given the lead that Blacklist International was able to get, Cade, they still deal so much damage onto the Lord. This is a Nathan from the jungle role, and that deals that can take the Lord so quickly.
This is actually really smart by Cade. They saw that Blacklist International were in that top side. They instantly go for the position, and look at Luis. Ooh. He's in for the flanks right now with the Glorious Pathway used. It is going to be Luis jumping onto three members, but look at Edward. He is actually, this is all for the Lord, and they're going to be able to take it away from Blacklist. A beautiful macro fight in that 12 minutes.
That was smart. That was really, smart. Really smart. Jeez. And Luis being the perpetrator of that, he's getting chased now.
Wow. Yeah. That is such a nice strategy coming out from Cade. Pincer maneuver. And you want to use your Electo final blow as well as your Glorious Pathway. So much floor skills coming out from Cade that they took advantage of. And a clutch retribution from King to take the Lord.
Oh, Mikey. He might have just went in a little bit too aggressive there. But look at the damage coming from Feather Airstrike. Wow. Almost taking Oheb down. Whoa. Blacklist now. The tides have simply just shifted onto Cade's favor. As we said, the scaling is starting to come in.
It's important. It's so important because Prime, he's got the most valuable ultimate in this game right now. And, you know, as you mentioned before, Wolf, Luis is doing a really good job at forcing Oh My Venus to use his ult rather early. And at least Haji has to try and protect himself. He knows that he's going to be safe, but if they can time their ultimates a little bit better, I think Blacklist International could potentially bait Cade into a fight that they cannot win. If they get Luis out of position, and more importantly, so bait out Takashi's Glorious Pathway, they could look to turn the tides.
It's all about the floor skills now for Cade. As well as Blacklist International, you have the second skill coming out from the Estus, as well as the ultimate from Haji to control the area. But Cade, the coverage that they were able to get from this Feathered Airstrike, as well as the Glorious Pathway, is just way too good. And I love the fact that they're using it like strategically. They were able to get the pincer maneuver against Blacklist International, and Blacklist International definitely weren't ready for that. Now for Cade, if they want to take this game in and maybe control the later portions of the game, all they have to do now is to be patient. Use their macro play from this Benedetta to just split push the map and then group together with the Nathan. Have the Hylas as well as the Matilda always be with the Nathan so that they can protect this late game carry.
This is honestly, right now, so insane by Cade. They've actually shifted the gold lead right now. And oh, wait a minute, Mountain Shocker will be able to reveal the opponents, and they will have to run out of that death bush.
Yeah, wow. This is going to be another slow game. As we said, Cade, in their victories, it's always the late game. The super late game, in fact. 22-minute game they won against Onyx Esports. and back-to-back games against their previous match, which was it went 17 minutes and 19 minutes. So they really, really want to take it into the late game. And so far, they have the better late game composition compared to Blacklist International.
Well, I would say that there's an argument to be made there as well here. Because
that
right
is
now,
true.
Haji,
that is true.
Yeah, Haji is going to be scaling up pretty well. They may not necessarily have the burst, but the fights drag on out. I think Blacklist does have them beat in that department. But who would have thought it would have come to this, right? 43k to 43k. Luis should be okay here. Oh, this is starting to get concerning.
Oh, no. This is not going to be looking good for Luis. He's going to be caught in the pincer maneuver, and that's a 4v1. No, not even 4. It's a 5v1. They've actually put all their resources into the bottom side, and the thing is, Cade, they didn't have any setup.
Yeah, good read coming out from Edward as he forced the Electo Final Blow. And when the Electo Final Blow is already used by the Benedetta, by a split-pushing Benedetta, you know that he can be contested by the Arteez. And now, 22 seconds without this Benedetta, the macro play is going to side on, Blacklist International.
Oh, but look at the wave clear, man. The high ground potential of Cade is just insane with the Feather Airstrike and obviously King with the Entropy. But look, Blacklist International, they've finally taken down the kill. They've taken down Luis, and I think that guy is the most important member, right? Sure, the damage mostly is from King, from Prime, but Luis makes it happen.
Yeah, I think, you know, it's interesting to see that now Luis is in a position where he can't hard carry the game, but instead is trying to make openings for his members like King, and as well as believing in Prime that he's going to step up this game and make it happen. And so far, Prime has been doing that once he's gotten his items, his positioning, he's been warming up for this moment, and hopefully it's going to pay off here, because so far they're doing pretty well against Blacklist International.
Yeah, Blacklist International trying to open up the map right now. Doesn't have the Mountain Chakra Edward already popped in, but it's going to be actually Edward caught in the midst of it all right now. Still able to run away with the help of the real world manipulation, but that is two ultimates burned away before anything even happens. The Lord, though, was just going to get bursted down. And, oh, wait a minute. Cade, they are miscommunicating right now. The Nathan is all alone, and he's going to get taken down. Edward now looking for a kill onto King. Still able to kite away for now, but the damage will come through again. Mikey comes in for the Circle Eagle, looking for the re-engage. The final blow will come in for the follow-up, but he is just simply way too tanky, and it might be Mikey losing out on that immortality. Still has the guiding wind, but Blacklist now on the go with the Lord.
Edward the Uranus, that was so amazing. He kept on top of the King, and Cade is now crumbling.
Oh, but wait a minute. Feather Airstrike able to zone away the members right now. The Lord will be marching down, getting the hits onto the turret. Tekashi is able to get the stun onto Edward, but look at Tekashi. Immortality will be popped by both Mikey and Tekashi. The Lord is marching down and hitting onto the base. Blacklist International have cracked Cade's defense, and that is them with the 4,000, now a 5,000 lead back in the game.
Yep, and they have to start spreading their resources here. They've already claimed all the tier 2s. If they want to go for this inhibitor, they have to stick around as Edward's zoning them off.
Oh, the real world manipulation just does so much damage with Edward as well. Just being such a nuisance to that back line. And now it might be an all-out fight, but the airstrike hasn't popped. Luis goes into the backside, able to pierce and get some damage out of the way. But Mikey, he's going in. He's forced to go in. That was a beautiful forced error by the side of Blacklist International. And look at the damage from Oheb, almost one-shotting Prime. Luis now caught in the 1v4, still able to dash away with the Eye for an Eye, but why? Will be able to pick him up with the passive. The double kill picked up by Blacklist. The triple kill is in his sight. He's gonna go for it. It's gonna be the triple kill. Will it be the Maniac? It is gonna be the Maniac. No, it's not. It's only the Maniac. No more. But what a first game, a statement from the Filipino champs.
A lot of respect coming in from these Filipino champions here. They could have gone with a more greedy comp, but instead they played with their regular slow roll, things that they're comfortable with, understanding the composition that they've been playing throughout the MPL Philippines. Here. They take the first match against Cade. However, you can definitely tell they are not pulling their punches. Now you